I'm going to ask all of you, just tell us one thing, an anecdote or something your father or family, senior family member told you that has really made an impact in your life, in running a business.
In my case, the real anecdote comes from my grandfather, and he ran 300 buses with zero late coming and zero breakdown in 1930s.
Wow.
Okay?
Wow.
And that is why TVS was trust. You could set your watch by the TVS bus. Wow. And the one thing that was dinned into us is trust with customers, trust with employees, and trust in the family. And the T in TVS was always said to be trust.
Oh, I see. They told
you that. And therefore, it is that single-minded focus on employees and trust and family, because ultimately you cannot serve the customers with trust unless your family and employees have trust.
What did your father, you remember?
So two interesting things. One, he said, remember, this is your business, but it's not yours. Yet you are actually a trustee of anybody and everybody who's connected to this business.
Wow.
So if you understand that your role is of a trustee, and your behavior actually tends to be of a certain type, which is long-term beneficial.
Right.
The other interesting thing he said was, do not look at people as high or low, senior or junior. A good idea will come from anybody, anywhere, anytime. Keep your mind open.
Right. Very interesting. Yeah.
I'll just say two points, two things which impacted me a lot. One is when I just finished school and you get into that phase
which
of
school?
College. The best school in India. The best school in India. So when I finished school, we had this custom of going to the factories from a very young age, from class 7, class 8, all summer holidays we were working in factories and all that. So my father told me very clearly, he said, beta, you're now going to get into the next phase of your life. My advice for you is to remember that work is worship.
I just want to ask you, Sunil, that what would you want to be remembered as when you finally give up the business, or you just walk away a little bit?
I must say, all these questions are much better than the anchor's question. Bloody good question.
So
yes.
What would each of you be remembered as? I even know Ajay's family, Ajay's dad, I had known for a while.
So he's passing the buck to you. What do you want to be remembered as?
Aren't we talking about family business now? This is going beyond all that.
This yeah. is the core. Don't avoid. My only job is to make you answer the question.
Thank you.
No. It's a tough thing, but I would put it this way. I would say, frankly, I just hope that I'm perceived as fair and who's equitable to the family
right.
and to all people I'm interacting with
right.
without moving in any biased way or without
right.
moving in any
fine.
Unfair manner. I think that's the main thing.
So, as you know, Naveen, I'm quite deeply involved, and I'm talking other than business right now, in education, in healthcare, in arts, and in culture. And I think it is important for any society, if you want to build a civilization, and I'm not just talking a nation state now, that engineering, accounting, and legal stuff is absolutely critical. It's not enough. The softer aspects in our life, in some sense, are more important to provide the balance and to provide the longevity of quality of life for the entire nation. So nation building is as important as running our own individual businesses for the family.
Excellent. You can't duck.
I can't duck. Okay. There are two things that are very important to me. The first thing is that as the great founders of the businesses that you see around you, which are well known, respected for trust, integrity, and contribution, I think lay the similar foundation. So not starting with mine, but as they say in Tamil, seven and seven generations, which means for 14 generations it will continue, is leave behind a legacy of values that will make it continue.
Values.
The second one that I have, which is very passionate about, we work in about 5,000 villages in livelihood programs,
5,
women empowerment program. We have almost 100,000 women in micro enterprises, maybe cows, sheep, chickens or basket weaving or whatever, earning about 40,000 rupees a year. So I would like to be remembered for TVS having maintained trust to society on which they have grown by contributing back to a new prosperous India.